Hi, my name is Shabani Rajay, and I'll be presenting on behalf of my team. I'll be presenting on electrodermal activity experiment to enhance divergent thinking in engineering students. So currently, the problem is that divergent thinking is a problem-solving skill that many STEM students currently lack in classrooms. In our research, we define divergent thinking as the focus of finding many different original and diverse solutions for a given problem. Traditionally, engineering curriculum has focused on convergent thinking, which is finding one solution or the correct answer. However, research shows that divergent thinking is crucial to creativity and the design process, which is really important to engineers. In fact, the top three job skills that are in demand in 2020 include complex problem solving, critical thinking, and creativity, all of which are really important to divergent thinking. So our proposed solution is to first investigate whether divergent thinking can be analyzed through electrodermal activity or EDA sensors. EDA has been linked to functionality of the sympathetic nervous system, meaning emotional and physiological responses could be shown by measuring EDA levels. We have proposed to use the alternative uses task, which is a psychological test. And research has shown that the AUT can be used to evaluate traits such as fluency, flexibility, and originality, which is what we will also be using it on. So for our methodology, we use the Empatica E4 wristband, which is similar to a watch, and this is used to measure EDA levels. The first part of the phase is the eligibility test. We developed this eligibility test so that it's a challenging puzzle-like questionnaire for the participant. The purpose of this is for the participant to ultimately show desirable results. In our research, we define desirable results as fluctuations in their EDA level. However, research shows that there's a small percentage of population that does not respond to EDA levels, meaning they're non-responders. So the purpose of the eligibility test is ultimately to eliminate any of the non-responders prior to them taking the AUT. The phase two is the modified AUT test. This has many yes or no like questions that focus on originality and appropriateness. So an example can be seen on the bottom left side where it says a hat is used to cover one's head and the participant would answer appropriately. The purpose of this is for the participant to really test if they can find what the originality of an item is, and we can see if there are EDA fluctuations. As a result, we did 28 eligibility tests, and we kind of outlined the process flow in this flow chart. They started off with a questionnaire where we were able to check their eligibility so that we can really see if they have any health disorders that would affect the results of their EDA level. They then had to wear the E4 wristband so that we could collect baseline data for 15 minutes. And then they took the eligibility test, which is a puzzle-like questionnaire, answering the questions out loud while we observed their EDA levels. The middle two figures display the results from one participant. The top figure displays the eligibility test results, and you'll want to focus on the blue line because that displays the phasic changes or the peaks. And the bottom figure displays the results from our modified AUT. So you can see that the EDA levels had more significant fluctuations in the eligibility test. We noticed that when individuals answer more open-ended questions and are not constrained to time, they had increased EDA levels. However, with the modified AUT, you can notice more flattening EDA levels. We came to the conclusion that the questions in the modified AUT were unchallenging, leading to the participant to feel disengaged. So, in conclusion, our preliminary results show a correlation between neurobehavioral performance and divergent thinking tasks. Study can then be extrapolated to classroom pedagogy and forms of instruction. For example, a professor can decide if they find that students are more engaged in the traditional lecture-based setting or active participation. For future work, we would like to conduct classic AUT instead of the modified AUT. A classic AUT would be when you ask the participant to name alternative uses to a simple object such as a paperclip. And also, we would like to experiment the AUT in the fall of 2020 due to the current situation. Thank you for your time, and I'll open it up to questions now.